Now that we understand how a pitch rate can affect the aerodynamics, let's look at how a pitch rate affects longitudinal trim. Okay, so in the previous video, we learned about these two delta. These are difference in angle of attack due to pitch rate. Remember, because our horizontal now has a higher angle of attack because of this pitch rate, and the wing, because it sits in front of the center of gravity, or the aerodynamic center of it sits in front of the center of gravity, has a lower angle of attack, at least for this example. Okay, so we're going to now look at how these changes in angle of attack can be included in a pitch trim case. And to do that, we're actually going to step back and look at the simplified pitch trim problem that we looked at before when we talked about longitudinal trim and stability. So if you haven't watched those videos, you might want to go back and review that, or those sections in the book by Phillips. But let's just review really quickly what we did with that. So we had two governing equations. This is our lift equation. We have lift from the wing and lift from the horizontal, both contributing to our overall lift, which is also equal to W cosine gamma, where gamma was our climb angle, non-dimensionalized by the dynamic pressure in the wing area. We also had an equation for the pitching moment, and that included the pitching moment from the main wing, the pitching moment from the horizontal, and then also the lift from the main wing multiplied by its moment arm relative to the center of gravity, and the lift from the horizontal multiplied by its moment arm from the center of gravity. Okay, so that was our total pitching moment, and that needed to sum to zero to be trim. Of course, in order for us to be trim in lift, we had to have the total lift on the aircraft was equal to the weight times the cosine of gamma. Okay, and then we said, well, the lift on the wing actually is composed of a lift slope multiplied by some angles, you know, the angle of attack plus the mounting angle of the wing and the zero lift angle of the wing. Same with the horizontal, it's composed of a lift slope of that horizontal stabilizer plus an angle of attack of the horizontal, a mounting angle, zero lift angle of attack, and then downwash. So we've got this epsilon d naught, epsilon d alpha. There were two components to downwash, one of those proportional to alpha, and then the deflection of the elevator and the effectiveness of the elevator. And then we have the pitching moment from the horizontal, which if you have some camber in that horizontal, then you'll have some CMH naught. And then, of course, you'll have a change in pitching moment with elevator deflection. So all of this we used, we plugged this information back into these two equations, and we're able to write a lift equation and a pitching moment equation that depended on alpha and delta E. And then these are two equations that we could solve simultaneously to solve for alpha and delta E to trim, to give us a trim condition based off of a current weight and climb angle and velocity, okay? So we're gonna use the same approach now, but we're gonna include the effects of pitch rate. So let's just look at where that would be included. So the lift on the main wing now, we would need to add in one more angle here. This is our delta alpha W. So we can say plus delta alpha W right there. Which is equal to 2 times LW over C bar W times Q bar. Okay, so we have, that's the angle of attack caused by a pitch rate. And then right here, we'd also add in as another component here to the horizontal, a delta alpha on the horizontal, which is equal to 2LH over C bar W times Q bar. Okay, so those were the expressions we developed in the earlier video to look at how the angle of attack changes on the main wing and the horizontal, and that depends, it's proportional to the distance of that lifting surface from the center of gravity. So we've got L sub W there, L sub H right there, okay? So now we can write this, our general equation as the total lift is equal to some CL zero, and that's the lift when there's zero angle of attack, zero elevator deflection, and zero pitch rate, plus CL alpha, or the change in alpha times alpha, plus CL Q bar times Q bar, plus CL delta E times delta E. So that should look familiar to you if you had watched these the static trim videos earlier. And then our pitching moment, we can write that as some pitching moment when angle of attack, Q bar, and delta E are all zero, plus a change in pitching moment with respect to alpha times alpha, plus a change in pitching moment with respect to Q bar times Q bar, plus a change in pitching moment with respect to delta E times delta E. Okay, so these are our two governing equations, our lift and our pitching moment. And this guy, the pitching moment has to be equal to zero. You know, that whole equation has to sum to zero in order to be trim. And the lift has to sum, just like it did before, has to be, equal to this guy if we're in steady level flight, or excuse me, steady climbing flight, with the cosine gamma there being our climb angle. Okay, so so we can actually write this in this exact same form as we did before, where we have a lift slope with respect to alpha, a change in lift with respect to delta E, change in pitching moment with respect to alpha and CM delta E multiplied by alpha and delta E. So we'll leave those on the left-hand side. And so these are, so that's this term here, CL alpha, the CL delta E, the CM alpha, CM delta E. And then the other things we're going to move to the right-hand side. So we have the lift coefficient is already over there, and that used to be equal to this. We're actually going to swap it out for something else in just a moment here. Then we have minus CL0. The CL0 needs to come to the other side. And then now we need to add one more term here, which is going to be a minus. So let me get rid of this right there. This is going to be minus CL Q bar times Q bar. Okay, and then the pitching moment, same type of thing. So we've got CM alpha and CM delta E that stay on the left-hand side there. And what we're going to move to the right-hand side is minus CM naught. That's that term right there. Of course, this whole thing had to sum to zero. So originally that was equal to zero, but we moved the CM naught over, and then we're going to also move over the CM Q bar here. So we'll have minus CM Q bar times Q bar. Okay, now I'm going to do two things, and then we would close the brackets here to solve this. But I'm going to do two things before we finish this off. So I'm actually going to swap out these Q bars. So Q bar is equal to, we saw in the previous video what Q is equal to, and then you can non-dimensionalize it. So you can write that Q bar is equal to N minus 1 times G C bar W over 2 V squared, okay? So I'm going to use that Q bar in here. So actually, I'm just gonna leave it for now, but this is Q bar and Q bar, but we're gonna plug in this expression for Q bar in the next step. And the second thing we're gonna swap out is this lift coefficient here. We can actually write that in terms of our load factor. So that's going to be N times CW. CW is my weight coefficient. So remember that N is defined as lift over weight. And so that can be a coefficient of lift over a coefficient of weight. And so a lift coefficient would be equal to N times the weight coefficient, okay? So we'll plug those in. And when we do those substitutions, and then all we're left with here is a 2x2, two equations, two unknowns. Alpha and delta E are still our unknowns. And so for any given pitch rate, Q bar, we can solve for the alpha and delta E required to trim, okay, to keep us in this trim condition at that pitch rate. All right, so because this is a 2x2, and then everything over the right-hand side is a known value, we can solve analytically for alpha and delta E. And so that, when we do that, we'll get this solution here. Okay, so that's the solution. This is the solution for alpha and delta E. And And notice we've swapped out N times CW. That was our lift coefficient before, but this is now our load factor times our weight coefficient. Again, load factor times weight coefficient here. And then the Q bar, we've swapped out this expression here. So the N minus 1 G times C bar W over 2V squared. That is equal to our dimensionless pitching rate, okay? So that shows up in both of these equations. And one thing we can check is that if we're in steady level flight, that's a 1G maneuver. And so we could plug in 1 for N, and we see that one minus one is zero. And so this entire term here, I'll just put a line through it. So for N equals one, that's a 1G maneuver. This all goes away and this all goes away because N minus one is zero. And then this N is one, this N is one. And so we're left with our weight coefficient. And so then what we get for the rest of this, if we were to just look at the remaining solution here, this is what we got in our previous development when we solved that analytically, or we could solve that analytically and get that solution. Okay, so that's for a 1G maneuver. I'm going to take that stuff off, though, because in general, this is the solution that we have. Okay, so for any pitch rate, this is our solution. Now again, this is a simplified wing and tail model here. Okay, so a couple things I want to point out. If we come back over here, one thing is that so we had this lift coefficient here, and when we wrote the equation in this form here, we took the derivative of that with respect to alpha. So we took the derivative of this equation with respect to alpha. Well, because the wing has an alpha in it and the horizontal tail has an alpha in it, you know, we have the lift coefficient of the wing, the lift coefficient of the horizontal there. When we took the derivative, we found that we had, in fact, I'll scroll down here. We had this derivative of lift with respect to alpha that depended on the lift slope of the main wing and the lift slope of the horizontal. We then took the derivative with respect to delta E, and that was this expression here. Well, we also need to take the derivative with respect to Q bar. We can come up with an estimate for that CL Q bar by taking the derivative of this equation with respect to Q bar. And so you can see that we've got the lift coefficient of the main wing and the horizontal, and both of those are now gonna have a Q bar in it. So when we take the derivative, we're gonna end up with this this value here multiplied by whatever is out front here and whatever is out front here. Same thing here, when we take the derivative of this with respect to Q bar, we're going to end up with the 2 LH over C bar times the CL H alpha, and then that's all going to get multiplied by this stuff out front for the total change in lift with respect to Q bar. Okay, so let's just write down what those would be to be a little bit more complete here. So what we needed here was a CL Q bar. These are new derivatives, CL Q bar and CM Q bar, okay? So CL Q bar, when we take the derivative, what we'll get is 2 LW over C bar W times CL wing alpha plus 2 SH LH over SW C bar W times eta H CLH alpha. Okay, so that's our change in lift coefficient with respect to pitch rate. We can do the same for the pitching moment, so our change in pitching moment with respect to pitch rate. And again, this is our equation up here, our pitching moment. It, of course, depends on the lift coefficient on the main wing and the lift coefficient on the horizontal, which are now functions of Q bar. So when we take the derivative of this equation with respect to Q bar, what we'll get is minus 2 LW squared over C bar W squared times CL wing alpha minus 2 SH LH squared over SW C bar W squared times eta H CLH alpha. Okay, So these are two new derivatives that we need in order to solve this this system of equations here, the CLQ bar and the CMQ bar. Now this guy right here, this CMQ bar, this is called the pitch damping derivative. So this is a measurement of how much pitch damping we have. In other words, this is when we have a pitching rate, we're going to find that the aircraft naturally creates a pitching moment that opposes our pitching rate. And actually, we can see that right from this equation here. You can see we've got a negative right here and a negative right here. And then everything inside of here is going to be positive, because it doesn't matter if our LW is positive or negative. It doesn't matter if that surface is in front or behind of the center of gravity. It's going to get squared. And so we're going to be left with a positive value here. Of course, C bar squared is also positive. And then the area of the horizontal, the area of the main wing, C bar here is positive squared. And again, the length, the distance to the horizontal is going to get squared. So it doesn't matter if that horizontal is in front of the center of gravity or behind, its distance is going to get squared. And so the effect here is to always decrease the CMQ bar, right? Because these are negative out front. Everything else inside of here is positive. So you can see that our pitch stability derivative, our pitch damping derivative will always be negative. And so that means that whenever we have, for example, let's think of a positive pitching rate. So if we're pitching upward with a positive pitching rate where Q bar is positive, let's say that Q bar is positive, then the pitching moment from that will be negative. Okay, so there will be some negative pitching moment that's opposing that pitching rate. And then likewise, if Q bar is negative, then the pitching moment will be positive. So if we're pitching down at some rate, then we're going to naturally have an aerodynamic pitching moment that's opposing that pitching rate, and that will be positive, okay? So that's called our pitch damping derivative. We're going to find that that's a very important derivative in the next couple lectures. We're going to see how that couples actually with our pitch stability derivative, CM alpha, which we've already discussed at length in the longitudinal and trim and stability lectures. We know that the pitch stability derivative is very important. We're going to find that the pitch damping derivative is also important for evaluating the handling qualities, or the, you know, how well this aircraft is going to be maneuvered by a pilot. Okay, so that's our, just in summary, what we've looked at here is the longitudinal trim with a pitch rate. We found that we could solve that analytically. Again, this is only for a simplified wingtail analysis. So we basically assumed that the main wing and the horizontal both were lying on this fuselage reference line, just like we did before when we were looking at pitch trim. We also assumed that the center of gravity is right on this line, and that the distance here was L sub W and L sub H. So just like before, and then we just looked at this simplified analysis with a pitch rate, and we found that we could solve it analytically. And now, in the next video, we're going to look at the importance of this, what we can do now with this solution for our angle of attack and delta E to understand the maneuverability of the aircraft.